In less than 2 weeks, 17-year-old Gorgia girl Amber is supposed to become a gypsy bride.
A Gorgia is the exact opposite of a Romney. I'm wondering to myself, you know, is it gonna work? I hope it works. I hope they're happy.
Amber's not used to, you know, this kind of thing. She's only 17, you know, she's never done this before. She's not sure how a Romney wedding goes, you know what I'm saying?
My cousin Flora is coming down and helping Amber get ready, you know, for the wedding stuff.
Like Amber, Laura married her Romanichal husband Gus at 17. Now a mother to Haley and Savannah, she is the perfect gypsy housewife.
I can teach her everything I know about being a Romney wife. I can teach her everything I've learned. She will be marrying into the strong bloodline of Romneys. So I had to Romneyfy her.
Laura's first task is to find out whether the local bride store has any dresses fit for a gypsy wedding.
When it comes to a Romney wedding dress, you need to be big, all blinged out, as gorgeous as you can get it. That's how we like our stuff, big and fancy and bling bling. So that's what we're looking for today, is some bling in these dresses.
What do you think about this one?
It's all right.
While these designs may work for gorgeous brides, they don't come close to what Laura has in mind.
I would not get my dress from here. I do not like it. When you walk down that aisle, you gotta have attitude. I want you to pose it.
It is more comfortable than the last one.
Honey, you don't supposed to be comfortable on your wedding day. If you ain't got bruises and stuff after you put your dress on, it won't the right one.
Having the perfect dress is like the main part of the wedding. No, I still haven't found it.
For a gorger, the dress would have been fine. But when you're married to a Romney family, you want that bling. So she has to have that bling.
Sandra Charlie.
This is Amber.
Hi, Amber. What are you looking for?
I am wanting you to make my wedding dress. I was wanting to do white, and I wanted it to be strapless.
And I would assume Crystal would be the ultimate prize on this dress, I would assume, yes?
Yes.
Can I take the bottom of the end of the train? Can I put red roses?
Yeah.
Just so when you get down the aisle, there's a touch of red, because it'll be so beautiful.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to get it going right now. Okay, girls, we're in big trouble. I promised a girl an amazing dress, shoes, boots. I'm psyched to do it, psyched. The problem is we got 10 days. Mira, you got to sew lots and lots and lots of ruffles. Big crinolines, petticoats. You guys got a rhinestone. We got to get the rest of the girls in here. This is an emergency. But we're going to have to work day and night to get this dress up.
The wrong thing to have Sandra Chilla make our stuff, so I'm pretty excited that she got Sandra Chilla to make hers.
Amber's unable to fly to Boston due to her pregnancy, so Sandra will be making this dress blind.
Amber really wanted a simple dress. Gorgeous likes simple elegance. Gypsies, the more, the more, the more, the more. It's got thousands of Swarovski crystals, all been put on one by one by hand. She has individual silk roses that will have Swarovski crystal on them too when it's finished. The skirt is another story. It's got a train that goes on forever. It's covered in red roses. It's covered in crystal. When this dress gets on that truck, I want her to open that box and have a nervous breakdown.
Back in Boston, Amber's custom-made wedding dress is ready.
The dress is being shipped to Amber today. We had to break it down into parts in order to ship it. It's in three huge cartons. This isn't some simple wedding dress. This is a project on your body.
With just 3 days to the wedding, Amber and her maid of honor, Marlena, anxiously wait for the dress to arrive.
She's going to have a little bit of pain wearing this dress. It's about 75 pounds.
Look, we got the dress.
It's a big deal when she opens those boxes.
Oh my God. Look at that.
Oh my God. That is gorgeous.
Look. She told me on the phone, I don't want a giant size skirt. I'm nervous it's gonna be too big. And well, I gave her the giant size skirt.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
It's covered in about 300 red roses. It's got thousands and thousands of crystals all over the bodice.
Oh my gosh.
Wow.
Look at that.
No gypsy wedding dress would be complete without plenty of sparkle.
Oh my God.
That is gorgeous.
This
that
is
matches
crazy.
Your crown.
This is crazy. This is crazy.
If you really want to look like a gypsy, you need to have rhinestones and color and, you know, pizzazz.
Oh my gosh, gloves. Look at that.
Those are gorgeous.
Oh my gosh.
Oh my God, I love the shoes.
These are the bomb. The stuff that she's done, like, I didn't even know that it was possible. Like, I'm just like this small town girl trying to make it, you know? And then I get this awesome wedding with this beautiful dress, and it's like, I feel completely honored. Like, this is incredible. I'm gonna start crying. I'm getting teary-eyed. I'll never, ever forget this, ever.
Over at Big Tommy's house, it's chaos as the last-minute gypsy touches are applied.
I am blinging out my shoes the day of the wedding.
Very chaotic. A lot of my family is here in my dad's house. We got a full house right now, and everybody's running all over the place getting ready.
I'm just having a cold beer, trying to relax the nerves a little bit before we have that big moment.
The only arrangement Amber has left in Tommy's hands is transportation to the church.
It's almost 12 o'clock.
Unfortunately, he's forgotten.
A few hours from the wedding, and we don't yet have a limo, so we're working on that right now.
Father!
An unimpressed Big Tommy takes control.
With a dress as big as a house, she needs a limo to ride in. You know, I'm not planning the wedding. They're planning the wedding. Had I known he had not had a limousine, I would have made sure that he had one. Yeah, well, and her dress is as big as a house. The dress is not going to fit in a normal car without messing it up.
Without Laura's help, Amber and her gorgeous bridesmaids now have to put together her enormous gypsy dress, a dress weighing 34 kilos.
Oh, God.
Made up over 45 meters of fabric with a 6-meter train.
This is crazy.
Okay. Is it tight enough? Too tight?
This is exhausting.
Do you want to look good?
Yeah.
Do you want the dress to hang to be right?
Oh, I don't want all that weight on my stomach, though.
Now, the weight is evened out.
This is like wrestling. I'm breaking a sweat here.
Just call him back and tell him, make sure it's a super stretch, the best one he's got, make sure he's got champagne in there.
Sweet.
Good
job, Dad. Okay. Good job, baby. Right. We got it done.
All right,
we got it done.
We got it done. All right.
Put the beer in the limo, let's go.
Well, all right.
With her dress finally on, Laura gets to see Amber for the first time.
I love it. I'm telling you, I told you, she does some good work.
Amber is ready to step out into gypsy society. But first, she has to get out of the house.
Look, I can't even make it through here.
Whew. I wonder if I can go sideways.
And then, but nope, that ain't gonna work. No. We're gonna have to move that table, Sarah.
Yep.
Okay.
Oh, I'm stepping on it.
She's beautiful.
That dress was definitely Romney. I mean, you don't get no more Romney than that. All the bedazzles on her, sparkles, you know, that's what a Romney dress is. That's how it's supposed to be. This ring I give you as a pledge.
This ring I give you as a pledge.
My abiding loyalty and love.
Of my abiding loyalty and love.
I pronounce them husband and wife in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.